I am Eric Gonzalez, and I work on Android apps at Udacity. I started working on the Udacity app for a deadline we had of shipping the app the day of Google I/O. And so I joined the company about 5 weeks or so before we had to ship. And so moved to Mountain View and worked late and shipped the app with a small team. The way I familiarized myself with the code base was really more getting acquainted with the Udacity APIs more than the Android code. Most of the Android code is pretty straightforward in terms of Android development, but the way in which you fetch data from Udacity was quite different, and so that's where there was a bit of a learning curve. The activities in the Udacity app are pretty straightforward. They're grouped, of course, logically by the activity you normally do on the site or in the classroom. So we have the notion of a catalog, for instance. We have individual details for courses, and those are their own activities. Same thing for our authentication. You have activities for authentication or viewing your enrollments. Pretty much everything you can map to an activity that you do in the Udacity classroom maps to an activity in the Udacity app. So we use intents throughout the app pretty much everywhere. So whenever you transition between, like, let's say, login to the catalog or to your enrollments, those are all using explicit intents. So it's saying specifically, I know I want to transition from this activity to the next one. And these are maybe arguments or additional parameters that can be useful when loading that new state. So we use very few implicit intents in the app just because of the nature of it. We don't really have a lot of dependencies on, like, I don't have to scan a barcode or take a picture or things that would have a dependency outside of myself. There is one place, though, that we use implicit intents, and it's for sending support emails. So if you're having an issue with the app or you have an issue with your account, our app, of course, doesn't know what email client you use or how to send an email. So we use an implicit intent to generate that response so you can send a support ticket. When I want to make a button interactive for my layout, of course, when you have in your activity, I would have to find the view that maps to that button. And then once I find it, I can set a listener, a click listener on it, so that I can take a specific action on it if I want to. So that could be firing maybe a new activity, or that could be performing a network call, like enrolling a student in a course.